I was asked by a member of one of the many Facebook groups that I belong to about the easiest way of eliminating points that aren't really necessary in design. When you get a design that has a whole bunch of points in it, a whole bunch of nodes in it, what's the easiest way to get rid of some of those? Now, just as a demonstration, I'm going to use this design as my example here. If I click on just this vector here, then I tap N to go into node editing mode, you can see how many points are in this design. Now, in a previous video, I mentioned that I could tell that this design had been imported from a DXF file. And I can tell that by layer 0. And I'll go ahead and put a card up here so that you can, as a link to the video where I talked a little bit about this. When DXF files or DWG files are created, they are created with a large number of points every time something changes direction. And that's done that way as a way of coming back in, being able to come back in and edit. But when you get into situations like this where you have, there's just no need for this many points. When you get into V carving or just using V carve at all, anything really that has anything to do with the CNC, the fewer the points, the better. And something like this is borderlines on ridiculous, if I'm honest. Mainly because when this when VCarve goes to calculate this toolpath, it's going to have to calculate from this point to this point to this point to this point to this point. That's a lot of calculations it's going to go through. So that makes for large file sizes, that makes for slow cutting, and it can also lead to faceted corners, faceted edges on a rounded vector. So if you ever have a problem with faceting on a rounded corner like so, that may be the problem, is that you've just got a whole bunch of points and VCarve is treating it as though these were individual straight lines, which is the way this was drawn. And you can tell just by the sheer number of points involved. So how do we get rid of those? Well, I'll deselect by left-clicking and then right-click to come out of node editing mode. Well, the way we can get rid of a lot of these unneeded points is to just hold down Control and tap the letter A to select all of the vectors. And then come over here under Edit Objects to Fit Curves to Selected Vector. And we click on that, this form is going to open up. And it's also going to switch us into a kind of an abbreviated version of node editing, just so we can see how many points we have in the design. Now, our outside perimeter, we're fine. We've got the 4 points that you would expect to find in a circle. But back around in here, that's just way, way, way too much. So this is showing us what we have to start with right here. And we can do 3 different fit types up here when we convert these vectors to curves. We can use circular arcs, we can use Bezier curves, or we can use straight lines. Now, these are already straight lines, or so we want to get away from that. So we're going to try Bezier curves. And I prefer Bezier curves to circular arcs, mainly because if you saw my earlier video about what is a vector, and I'll put another card up above here to link you to that video if you missed it, you'll know that arcs are basically not as editable, or easily, it's not as easy to manipulate an arc as it is to manipulate a Bezier if you want to clean up a curve or something like that. So we can go ahead and check, see what it would look like if we went with circular arcs by simply clicking the radio knob over here in circular arcs. We don't want to mess with our tolerance. We want to make sure there's a check mark in keep sharp corners and not worry about the max angle. And we want to make sure there's a check mark in replace selected vectors. If we don't do that, it's just going to give us duplicate vectors, which we're going to have to track down and try to clean up. We'll come down here and we'll click preview. And we see just by converting two circular arcs from straight lines, we have really cleaned that up quite a bit and got rid of a few. But if we were to come in and try Bezier curves, I think we can get rid of even more. So we'll go over here and just select Bezier curves and click preview. And we see we have really reduced the number of points. So I think that that would be the way to go with this design. So we'll go ahead and click OK. Then deselect everything. Now we come back in to this vector that we had. And if I tap N for node editing, we have a lot fewer points down here. And the points that we do have are much easier to edit and manipulate should we decide that we need to. Personally, I don't see anything there that needs to be edited, nor do I, come on, click it, there we go, nor do I see anything here. We've got some that are pretty close together, but that's okay. This is not simple geometry. So now we'll go ahead and right click out of node editing mode, and we've really cleaned up the image. We've really cleaned up the and simplified the vectors on this so that VCarve has fewer paths to try to calculate. And it's not going to be much here on this particular piece of artwork simply because it's rather simple design. But if you're cutting something that's really complex that has a lot of vectors in it, or you can really cut down on the machining time as well. Now it may only be a few seconds, it may only be a few minutes, but if you have several parts to cut, those seconds and minutes can really add up fast. So you'll always get a better result with fewer points. You'll always get a smoother cut with fewer points, and you'll also make make it easier on VCarve, which also leads to shorter processing times and can lead to shorter machining times. So another thing that I have been neglecting in just about all of my videos is the fact that we need to save the design, save the patterns. Now we just went in and we made a large change, a huge change to these vectors, and we need to come up here and save those changes so that the next time, 6 months down the road, we decide to come back and reuse this pattern, we don't have to go through all this all over again. So from here we would go over and calculate our tool paths. Hold down Control, tap the letter A to select all of our vectors. Hold down Shift and click on the outside circle to deselect that one. Come up here to do a profile tool path. My cut depth is the depth of the material all the way through. I've got an 1/8 inch end mill. I'm going to do it in 8 passes. I want to cut to the inside of these vectors. For this demonstration, I'm going to leave all of this alone and calculate that toolpath, and then preview it. And we'll get nice, smooth cutouts. Okay, so I'm going to call that good for this video. If you got anything out of it, please give me a thumbs up down there. If you'd like to be notified the next time I post a video, please consider subscribing to my channel. But whether you subscribe to me or not, thank you very, very much for watching, and y'all take care.